You're about to listen to the nighttime show. Buckle up.
That's right. This is the part two of the nighttime show live. I'm sitting here with, of course, Mike Black. Our dear friend Matt Walker.
Hello.
And me, I'm
the
Stephen
start
Kramer.
Of the weirdest orgy
<It's>
ever.
So weird. Last week, you guys got to listen to the first half of the nighttime show live, which was Mindy Sterling and Johnny Manuel from America's Got Talent.
That guy is amazing, by
His
the way.
His voice is unbelievable.
Blew the roof off the place.
It's right? Like,
how did you pull off getting him on the show?
Because,
like, you know what he does, like, arenas. Yeah, did you just lie to him and tell him what the gig was?
No.
I want to be fair to the people listening because you're not going to be able to see this.
Yeah, no.
But as he was singing, we have a perfect view of the whole room while this is happening. The effect he had on women and men was unusual.
Yes.
Where, like, there were waiters and waitresses that stopped in their tracks while he was singing and got on their phones and broke up with their significant others because they thought, I might have a chance with Mr. Emmanuel.
100%. 100%.
It was crazy.
It was crazy.
Everyone in that room, if they didn't get laid that night, they were doing something wrong.
100%.
On their own.
Wait a minute. Did any of us get laid that night? Because I didn't.
No.
I tore into myself like nobody's business.
You're like, I'm going to give you so much pleasure. I'm going to give me so much pleasure.
I was like, honey, you don't even know. the songs I heard tonight, you are in trouble.
Lit some candles.
Yeah. Made a wish.
I feel like the amazing balance that we locked in with this past live show was that we had very funny people and we had something that no one had ever seen before, which was the eating contest.
Yeah,
which
will not be on here because it doesn't go well on
here.
Right.
But people, you can watch that. You'll be able to watch it
online.
YouTube. Yeah. And then having a singer from America's Got Talent blow the roof off a place. It was like the perfect date night. Like, like if you took a girl to,
you watch the woman deep throat sticks of butter.
Yeah, it's one of those things. You want to surprise a girl. You don't tell her, I'm going to take you to hear a singer and watch a lady eat a bunch of butter.
Right. But I feel like it's like, you know how people go to that Lucha La Boom?
Yeah.
Like, I feel like it's that kind of date night where you take someone, they've no idea what they're getting into. And by the time it's over, they're like, I've seen everything that there is in the world.
Wait, can you talk about, and I hope this doesn't offend her, but I want you to talk about the British fan that came to the show. And just, do you remember the exchange you had with her?
No, you tell.
Where she came out, she'd never done anything in America yet.
Right,
And
so she, just got off a plane, earlier that day?
Just got off a plane, fresh off. She comes to the show.
That was her introduction to America?
Our show was her introduction to America. And she comes up to Stephen, Stephen took a break at some point and she caught him in the hallway and goes, I've never seen anything like this. It's the most amazing thing I've ever seen. The man singing was wonderful. And then the man from Kids in the Hall, I love Kids in the Hall. And I can't wait to watch the lady eat the butter. That's how everyone felt.
Yes.
She was just putting it into words for the rest of us.
But. Yeah.
Yeah.
Man.
Quite the
show. Yeah, it really was. It was spectacular. Johnny Manuel was literally me watching him on TV and then going, I'm going to find this son of a bitch. And then I found him on Twitter and then just tweeted him a bunch of times until he agreed to get on
you
the
wore
phone
him down.
With me. I wore him down. And then he finally got on the phone with me.
That's my dating technique. Just wear him down.
Yeah. And then I pitched him real hard. I hard pitched him. I was like, you got to come do this show.
Played
please
the long game
the
with it.
Yep. And then he agreed that when he came back from Australia that he would come and do this. And he flew in from Australia. He was here for 2 days, did our show, and then he flew off to Europe to do a tour.
Yeah.
And he was a pro the whole time.
He was so damn good.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
When we start with Dave Foley, we start off by talking about Johnny Manuel.
Yeah, exactly.
Amazing.
Oh, no, you have to talk about it. Yeah. Because, so on this second half of the episode, we have Dave Foley from Kids in the Hall. which was produced by Lorne Michaels.
News radio and tons of other stuff.
So much cool stuff. And he tells some great stories about the origin of Kids in the Hall and of, like, you know, like of news radio and some of the awkward exchanges he had with Andy Dick while making it, which is so funny. And then, you know, just getting a chance to play one of our favorite sketches for him after he talked about it.
Yeah, and hearing the audience react the way they did. That was so really great.
I loved it so much. And then we had Britney Young, who is like my favorite cast member from the show Glow. She
killed it, and she was so charming and so fun to hear talk.
Yeah, she really was. And then she tells her audition story, which I think is just solid gold. It's fun.
Absolutely.
So yeah, you gotta sit down, just sit back, relax, and listen to the second episode.
I can't wait to hear the lady talk about Glow.
All right, here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, the star of News Radio, A Bug's Life, and Kids in the Hall, Dave Foley!
Yeah! Oh my God!
Everybody. Hi.
Wow.
So what will you be singing tonight, Dave?
What song?
What will you be singing tonight?
What will I be singing? The exact song. That song. Okay. Blind Faith. Yeah. you compare. You tell me who has a great voice. That was. I don't like following talent. Because that's comedy doesn't require any. Sure. That's the charm of comedy. It's you don't have to have any legitimate skill to do comedy. But singing, that's an actual skill. And
sure.
It's quantifiable, good or bad.
Right, right, of course.
Comedy's all opinion.
Absolutely.
You know?
Now, I'm such a massive Kids in the Hall fan.
I don't blame you.
It's one of the greatest television shows of all time. And it's one of the best sketch comedy shows ever made.
Well, thank you.
How did that get formed? Will you walk us through a little bit of the forming of the group?
A lot of it happened because none of us could get a job at Second City back in the early 80s. I met Kevin McDonald at a Second City workshop. My very first class, we were paired up to do a mirror exercise. Which is a lame improv exercise, and we managed to make each other laugh in this lame exercise. We thought, oh, that guy's funny. And after that, he asked me to join his improv team, and which became the first version of the Kids in the Hall, which then later merged with three guys, some guys from Calgary, where Mark and Bruce were a part of. Yeah. And then we did shows in Toronto for about 4 years to mostly empty houses for a lot of it. And then after a while, we kind of became a hit in Toronto and got scouted for Saturday Night Live.
Really?
Yeah. And that was...
Oh, my God. What a strange move that would have been if all of you guys would have just joined SNL.
And that was 1985 when we all auditioned for SNL. And Mark McKinney and Bruce McCullough were hired as apprentice writers that year on Saturday Night Live, which if any of you are old enough to remember the Robert Downey Jr.
Year...
Yeah. Arguably the worst season ever of Saturday Night Live.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
Also, arguably, it was all Mark and Bruce's fault. So after a year of writing down there, they kept coming up to do shows with us, and then Lorne kept hearing from people like Marty Short and Catherine O'Hara and Dave Thomas that he should see the Kids in the Hall do a show together. Sure. And so Lorne flew up at the end of that season of SNL and saw one of our shows in Toronto, and after that decided to fire Mark and Bruce and give us our own show.
That's amazing.
Yeah, we just basically we did this nightclub show every Monday night for 4 years, and that's really all we did before we had a TV show.
we had Scott Thompson on a show here. We had him on the nighttime show.
All right, what did he break? How much is it?
God, he broke a lot.
Yeah.
Actually, he wasn't the one who broke.
It was Andy Dick who broke.
It was Andy Dick. Andy Dick almost got us thrown out of this club.
Yeah,
On his birthday.
It was my...
On his birthday?
It was his birthday. I baked a cake of Andy Dick's face. You know what? If you pull up, you can go to Google, just Google Andy Dick, the nighttime show, and almost right away you'll see. I made him a cake of his face. We baked it for him. We gave it to him on stage, and then he picked it up and went, "For me? No. For you!" And threw it at a woman sitting right there. Yeah. Hit her, and it went all over her. And then he started crying and goes, "What have I done?" And he's holding it up on stage and modeling with it. I don't know if you can find it.
I don't know if you know this about Andy, but it's a true story. He's a sociopath.
Oh, is that?
Yeah.
Is that true?
Yeah, yeah, it's actually true. True story. Is that?
No, so that's
close. No. It's a.
You realize just doing a search for Andy Dick, the NSA is now tracking you.
Yeah, that's a good possibility.
That's all it takes now.
You're on a watch list.
He is considered a domestic terrorist at this point.
Absolutely. Yeah, I mean, yeah.
Mostly to the kitchen staff of every restaurant in L.A.
Yeah, I didn't know that he... this is so funny, but years and years and years ago, we're talking like 10 years ago, I didn't know he was banned from this club. I didn't know he was not allowed in. And I was standing out on the street. He pulled up on the street, and I went, "Oh, my God, Andy Dick." I was like, "This is so cool." And he goes, "Do you think I can come in?" And I go, "Oh, there he is. There's Andy on stage." And that's the cake in his hands there. Mm-hmm.
He brought that guy with him, who I don't know who that guy was.
Wasn't that Dino Stamatopoulos?
That was Dino Stamatopoulos. Yeah. There we go. Yeah. That's the cake that he threw at a lady.
Aww. He took a bite out of his own face and then threw it at a lady.
I ran into him on the street and I go, "Oh, would you..." I don't know why we're turning this into an Andy Dick conversation, but I did say to him, he goes, "Do you think they'd allow me into the club?" I go, "Of course they'll allow you into the club. You're Andy Dick. You were on the Ben Stiller show." I was so excited. And I go, "Come with me." And I walk him in, and I walk him in, and one of the managers goes, "What the fuck are you doing? Andy Dick can't come into this club. He's banned from the club." I go, "He is." He walks through these doors. Joe Rogan is on stage. And he walked right up, took a microphone, and walks up to Joe and goes, "I'm Joe Rogan. I think I'm good looking." And he starts heckling him on stage. And Joe's like, "What is happening?" I almost got in trouble. I almost got in a lot of trouble. We heard a story about Scott Thompson. How he got into Kids in the Hall is that he was sitting in the audience bothering you? Is that true?
Well, not so much bothering us as we were doing a sketch that for some reason involved us taping jelly donuts to the bottom of all the seats in the theater, and that was going to be in the sketch at the end of the show. It was going to play a role in a sketch at the end of the show. But near the beginning of the show, Scott found that there were jelly donuts taped under the seats and started peeling them all off and throwing them at us. In his mind, he thought, "This is my way in." Right. Yeah. And we didn't know it was him for like a year. I think he was in the group before we found out it was Scott that threw all the donuts at us.
Oh, my God.
Which, oddly enough, I have a story about Andy Dick, which also was I didn't know for a year that this was Andy. I was in L.A. doing a show with the Kids in the Hall, we were over at that Chinese restaurant on Fairfax.
Genghis Cohen?
No, not the... the famous one from the 40s and... That doesn't matter.
People are just making up names.
Yeah, but I was at the bar and I just met Janine Garofalo and we were talking and having a lovely time, and this man kept coming up behind me and saying, "Why don't you just fuck her? Why don't you just fuck her? Just fuck her." And I kept saying, "Please go away, sir. Am I allowed to say fuck her on this show?"
Yeah, okay. Say what you want.
And then eventually I said, "Look, sir, if you don't go away, I have not said this as an adult, but if you don't go away, I'm going to punch you." And years later, when I was working on news radio, and he goes, "Do you remember meeting me at the Formosa?" It was the Formosa Cafe. "Do you remember meeting me at the Formosa?" I said, "No, I don't." And that's when I found out it was Andy that I almost beat up.
Oh my God, that's amazing.
Yeah. What a strange wingman that is.
Do it.
Just fuck her.
Let's talk about there's some credits that you show up. You've got some interesting credits, and we were going through your history.
You were in Anne of Avonlea.
Which?
Yeah.
Anne of Avonlea.
Oh, that's not one of the more embarrassing ones. No, that was also 1985.
Yeah, that was that was my sister's favorite show, so I know I saw it because we only had one TV. I don't remember you. Sorry. But because we went to the Anne of Green Gables house on vacation to make her happy.
Oh, my God. Your parents are boring.
We're redheads. It's like our only idol. That's all we got.
Make some noise, Anne of Green Gables fans. Yeah. Let's hear it.
Hilarious. Hilarious. I love it.
Yes.
What about Three Men and a Baby? You were in Three Men and a Baby.
Also in 1985.
Oh my God.
It was a good year.
There was this casting director in Toronto named Stuart Aitken, who in 85 decided that he just really liked me and got me like one line in everything that was shot in Toronto that year.
Oh my God.
Yeah, like I was also in a thing called Shadow Cries in the Darkness, I think it was called.
Yeah.
Starring Treat Williams, also 85.
Yep, Williams.
And last year I got to work with Treat Williams for the second time in my career. Oh, in a Jennifer Lopez movie. So I got to see Treat again. Say, do you remember me? And he didn't. He's an asshole.
Yeah. What about can we talk about It's Pat?
Sure. Happily.
Yeah. How did you get involved in that? Was it through Lauren, or how did you end up getting pulled into that?
I got a call. Weirdly, I was in London.
Yeah.
And I was on my way home from Kenya. So we were in London, and we were going to spend a week in London. And like the day we got into London, I got a call from my agents tracked me down in the hotel and said they want you to fly to L.A. to audition for this movie. And I said, well, I just got to London, and you know, we're hanging out here, but they faxed me the entire script that night. I'll tell you this, script was really funny.
Oh wow, really?
I read the script, well, this is really funny, and I loved Julia Sweeney. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and sure. They wanted me to fly, so I flew out and auditioned for it in flew from London to LA and auditioned and got the job.
Oh my God.
It was an audition gig, you know.
That's amazing. Yeah. Oh my God.
So
the movie didn't do very well.
Like, are you happy when you get cast to play an ambiguously might be man, might be woman kind of character? Like, how does that feel to be like, oh, Dave Foley's perfect for this?
For me, it was right in my wheelhouse. And actually,
Well, you did play a lot of women on
Kids. I played a lot, yes.
And who did you resemble most celebrity-wise?
Isabella Rossellini. I look startling like Isabella Rossellini. I got to say, on Conan O'Brien once, I was on with Isabella Rossellini.
Oh, my God.
And so they, without telling Isabella, they got a wig and cut it to look like her haircut that night. And they brought it out in the middle of the interview and said, you know, we hear a lot about you looking like Isabella Rossellini. And they put the wig on me, and we sat next to each other, and we looked a lot alike.
What's the sketch? This is just a personal question, but what is the sketch from Kids in the Hall that you get... that people come up to you the most about, that they go, oh my God, this was my favorite thing?
Dip my balls in it. that's not a Kids in the Hall sketch. That's a state sketch.
Yeah.
Although I did once have someone on lining up to get on an airplane get really mad at me because I refused to admit that I did a sketch called Dip My Balls in It. It wasn't me, man. It wasn't me. It was you!
Those were running at the same time, though, kind of.
They were on,
right?
Yeah, they started just a little bit after us.
Yeah.
But we never saw them because we didn't have MTV in Canada.
Right.
But there's a sketch that they call Girl Drink Drunk.
Oh, people, yeah.
Thank you.
Girl Drink Drunk.
People will bring that up to me a lot. Yeah. And what else? Bad Doctor. And, of course, the Daves I know is... People will shout that at me a lot.
Because you guys shot that in Canada?
We did. We shot it all in Toronto.
Was it all on stages, or was it out in the world alone?
It was mostly... like we did multicam stuff in studio with a live audience, right. And then we did film stuff, single-camera film stuff all over town. And, you know, it's built by the end of the run, I guess we were doing like 50-50.
Wow.
But all the film stuff we would run in studio for the live audience. So everything got real laughs. We never like sweetened anything.
Oh, so great. Yeah, it kind of feels like when you shoot in Canada, there's a lot of freedom to like, it seems like these are the Daves I know, like, those were not actors. Like, those are just people that you guys cast to come and do that.
Some of them. Yeah, some of them were actors. Some of them were other comics we knew. Some of them were just friends.
That's so great.
Yeah, because back in those days in Canadian show business, you just operated on the assumption no one would ever see it. You know, and it was a shock to everyone that people actually watched our show.
Oh, my God.
Well, we got to get some audience questions.
Yeah, we got to do audience questions.
Okay.
All right. I saw hands shooting up, so I'm going to start right here.
Hi.
Where are you?
Over here.
Don't hide from me.
Hi. Hi, my name's Haley.
Hi, Haley.
I've been a longtime fan, and I love seeing you in random things that I'm watching, and I just want to know, I loved seeing you on It's Always Sunny.
Oh, yeah.
And so, like, how did you get that? How did you get that role?
Those guys just called me up and asked me to come down. They said, "Well, are you free?" And I said, "Yeah, okay." And just went over and did. I forget. I think I did like 2 or 3 episodes of it. I forget now.
Yeah, you were good.
But it was really fun. And they're like, they give you a lot of freedom to play around over there, which is nice.
That was cool seeing you in it.
Why? Thank you.
I love it. Where else we got a question?
I'm gonna just stick right here.
You got a question up there?
Yeah.
I want to hear from the people in the back. I know we got Canadians back there.
We did the back
ball
last time.
Oh, okay. All right.
I'm trying to move it around.
Sorry, Ryan. Yeah.
Ryan knows what he's doing, Steven.
Jesus Christ, Ryan.
Really quick. What was more fun, filming on Monkey Bone or Postal?
Well, Monkey Bone, I just got to show my ass. Postal, I got to show my cock. So. It was in my gradual climb into the world of public nudity. They're both shit movies.
I love Monkey Bone.
You love Monkey? You're wrong. stop loving it.
Stop it.
Yeah.
What else?
We have another question right over here.
Another question from
over
there.
Remember?
That was me. Hi. Hello. I just had a really quick question. I actually remember you first because I lived in Argentina when I was 13.
And I was there hiding from my Nazi war crimes. That was before the Kids in the Hall.
It's true. It was actually Kids in the Hall. I remember introducing to that, and actually on HBO Olay, which is really interesting.
Mm-hmm.
That's where they first showed it. Did you have any other places where people recognize you from anywhere else in the world?
Well, weirdly enough, I was in Buenos Aires, and I was really startled to be stopped on the street a lot in Buenos Aires because I didn't think. And the weird thing was that my family, I flew down with my wife and daughter, and. And it's a long flight. It's like you're flying for 24 hours. And we got to the hotel in Buenos Aires, and they were crashed on the bed, and I was still awake. So I turned on the TV, and as soon as I turned on the TV, the Kids in the Hall came on. And I'm looking at them going, and they're passed out. And I'm going, we're on in Buenos Aires. And I couldn't believe it. And they ran it subtitled, so it was actually our voices and everything. Oh. So I was shocked. And then later, as we were wandering around, I kept getting stopped by people there. And I for a while thought, I'm going to move here. This is all right.
Mike has a question.
Yeah, I'd feel bad if I didn't get to ask you this. Me and my buddy in high school would watch Kids in the Hall all the time, and the hardest we ever laughed at anything was the Sizzler Sisters bank robbery.
Oh, yeah.
Anyone who remembers that sketch, it's amazing. But where did they come from?
The Sizzler Sisters started. It was literally we were actually shooting a Kathy sketch. I think it was a Kathy sketch, one of the secretaries, and about where Kathy fantasizes about winning a beauty pageant, and Kevin and I were just in drag for this beauty pageant sketch. And our wig genius, Judy Cooper Seeley, came out with these wigs she wanted us to try on. And she put them on us, and they still had the tags on them and everything. And we looked at each other, and we both went, no, we're not too clearly insane people. Just as soon as we put the wigs on and started improvising on these characters. You know, this is my sister Jerry. You know, and it literally just came immediately after we had these wigs on. And we did about like 10 minutes of just... Until eventually we got yelled at by our director to shut up. But it totally just came out of having bad fitting wigs on.
You can turn it up just a little bit.
People! Now, hands up!
You better do it, Pricks. We have a gun. I'm not afraid to use this. Put your hands up, up, up.
If you could do me a personal favor and pretend that he has a real gun, and if you could manage it to look a little bit frightened. Ah, ah, excellent, quite excellent. Thank you.
I said hands up, Pricks.
And take your shoes off. Take off your shoes. Yes, yes, yes. Now, 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 now. Pass them about. Mix them up. Mix up the shoes. Mix up the shoes. Mix them up. Mix them all. Mix them up. Get it.
Keep getting. Stop! All right, you. You fall in love with her. Sweet.
Yes, yes, Jenny. Yes, yes, yes. Now to business. Where's the manager?
Oh my God. Dave Foley, everybody. Give him a giant round of applause.
Thank you. Sorry for keeping you waiting.
No, you're the best. Keep it going, keep it going, keep it going. All right, we're gonna bring up the next guest, but hang on. Before we do, I gotta say a quick thing. Everybody, some people know this, but not everybody knows. Matt knows this. I fell coming out of the shower 2 days ago. I slipped and fell on the tile floor, straight down to my naked ass, landed on my back. Tore the toilet seat off of my toilet. When I did it, I did not have a concussion, did not break a rib, because the fatness here stopped me like an airbag. That is a true fact.
So the same thing that's killing you saved your life.
Oh, you son of a bitch. So for the last 2 days, I'm talking to Matt on the phone, and I'll go, oh, my back, oh, my back. And whenever I say that, Matt goes, what do you say?
Oh, my back hurts. My back hurts.
Quoting from when Apollo Ono and I met, and Apollo Ono had hurt his back. Let's play the back video, and I'm going to go prep the our next guest. Let's do this. Because I'm on Nickelodeon, I get to go to a lot of events I should not be allowed to attend. For example, the Kids' Choice Awards. I was a presenter last year.
When I was backstage at Kids' Choice Awards, and I was standing next to this guy, Apollo Ono. Do you guys know who this is? Yeah, I didn't know who he was. And he won like 9 gold medals for speed skating or something. I don't know how you do that, but he won a lot of medals. And I'm standing there next to him, and he goes like this. He goes, oh, my back hurts. Oh, my back. And I go, what happened to your back? And he goes, oh, I hurt my back, and I was snowboarding up in Big Bear. My back hurts. My back hurts so bad right now. And I was like, sorry about your back. And he was like, you ever go snowboarding? And I was like, no, I'm a grown-up. Did not know who he is. Okay. And he goes, lots of grown-ups go snowboarding. And I go, yeah, whatever you have to tell yourself. And he goes, did you watch the Olympics? And I go, no. And he goes, why not? And I go, I don't give a shit about the Olympics. I don't care about it. We have to, like, we're told we have to care. It's like, whatever, 4 or 8 years? What is it? Every 4 years. I don't even know. Where they do, it's like, we're supposed to get all psyched up on the javelin for, like, what, a day? We're all like, yeah, javelin, go! You can jump, I'm so proud of you! And then the rest of the 4 years, we don't give a shit about these people, and then suddenly we care again. Oh, you can swim, congrats! You know, like, I never cared about it. So I was like, I don't know about the Olympics. And he was like, I won 9 gold medals for America. And I was like, you did? And he was like, yeah, I'm Apollo Ono. And I was like, I thought he was black. And he goes, that's Apollo Creed from Rocky. And I was like, I don't know. And he was like, what an asshole. Walks away, walks over to Jonah Hill. And he goes, can you believe that guy? He doesn't even know who I am. And Jonah Hill goes, I don't know who the fuck you are either. It's a true story.
Oh, how about that?
Oh, my back. My back hurts.
All right, here we go. Let's bring...
Oh, my back. My back hurts. My
you
back.
Son of a bitch.
He gets mad, right. And then I was like, oh, my feelings are hurt. Oh, oh, my feelings are hurt.
Oh. You're the worst best friend. Hey, guys, if you're listening to the Nighttime Show, well, have I got news for you.
Better be good.
It is good. We have merch for sale. What? What? Merch? Huh? Yeah, that's right. We've got shirts. We've got shower curtains.
Oh,
we've
you
got
mean sweater. Merchandise.
Merchandise. What did you think I meant?
Mercenaries.
Oh, well, we also have those as well.
I thought we were going to send Robbie to kill people or something.
Robbie will fall down a flight of stairs.
Onto your enemies.
Right onto your enemies, 100%. We have all sorts of great stuff. If you go to thenighttimeshow.threadless.com, you can pick up any number of cool things. Sweaters,
like what
t-shirts.
Exactly?
Well, we have we have this artist named Mario Delgado who does all sorts of really cool artwork for our show, for our posters.
Right.
I'm sure if you listen
our
to the show.
Our wonderful posters that yeah, you've seen everywhere.
You've seen them everywhere. And if you've seen them everywhere, then you can get that artwork on sweaters, shirts,
what about out of the norm items?
Weird stuff. Pajama pants.
What if
leggings.
I want his art while I'm in the shower?
You can get a shower curtain.
You're kidding.
With our logo on your shower curtain.
What if I want to go to sleep with your head exploding right next to my
face?
Right
next to your face. Well, guess what? We got pillows, too. We got pillows.
Oh, my God.
Oh, man. We have bed sheets. We have Nighttime Show bed sheets and blankets.
What are we doing here?
So
Why are we ordering right now?
We should be ordering right now.
People could basically sleep with you and your pug jelly donut.
If you want to sleep with me, you can right now go to thenighttimeshow.threadless.com and go and I'll sleep with you. We're going to bring up our next guest. Here we go.
From Crazy Ex-Girlfriend, Those Who Can't, and She's Machu Picchu on Glow, Britney Young!
Yeah! Get out of here, girl! Who's a gay? Yeah! Keep it going, keep it going! Keep it going! I'll hold you close, victory! How are you?
I'm good, but come on, like, fire evacuation plan, big girl coming through.
Yeah, come on.
Like, what?
Give her a big round of applause. You guys watching Glow? Oh, my God. That show is fucking incredible.
They don't watch Glow.
Yes, they do.
I'm not one of those jaded actresses that are like, everyone watches my show. I know how it works.
No, it is a terrific... who watches Glow here? What, are you kidding me?
People love that show. Good.
I'm a
You're
big...
You're not for like 8 Emmys, that show,
yeah,
or something.
It's nominated...
It's 10 Emmys.
10 Emmys.
Thank you.
10 Emmys. That's a lot.
That's a lot.
Who are you guys nominated against? Do we have an idea?
He did it 10 Emmys.
You want to check and see who's nominated against? All right. Yeah, it is a terrific, terrific show. If you haven't watched it, it is about the it's based on a true story.
Yes.
How much of it? Well, let's explain to the audience. For those who don't know, Glow is the gorgeous ladies of wrestling.
Yes.
In the mid 1980s, these women came together and started a wrestling show of their own.
Yeah, their own show.
Yeah.
Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah, and it is a terrifically hilarious show and
it's
super
so good.
Cool.
It's
Everyone's
so good.
Amazing on it. What's the differences between the real show and your show?
I mean, I think the real show, okay, the real original Gorgeous Ladies of Wrestling mm-hmm. is like the WWE, WWF, but women wrestlers.
Sure.
Our show is kind of looking at the relationships of making that show.
Sure. Right.
So like if you watch any of the YouTube clips, which you should, it's an amazing black hole to get down.
I used to watch it.
You won't be like seeing like people falling in love and like things like that. Like you're going to see straight up wrestling and sketches and weird rapping because apparently the Chicago Bears were hot. Sorry, you guys. I have a cold. This morning it was Kathleen Turner. Now it's like weird kid. I apologize.
You sound great.
But yeah, so our show is more about the relationships. We do wrestle a lot. I wrestle too much.
Yeah, you're constantly putting
I'm
you in.
I think I wrestle more than I act, especially season two.
Yeah. Yeah, because your character, more than anything else, is you're from a wrestling family.
Yes, she's from a wrestling dynasty.
Yeah,
yes.
Wrestling dynasty. Yeah.
Yes, and I wrestle a dude. Two dudes.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, that was a spoiler. Watch the show. Ugh.
Yeah, you whoop their ass, though.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
Yeah.
Right, I love
it. So I have the list of shows they're up against.
All right, what
I could have told you.
Best comedy. Best comedy?
Atlanta. Oh, this,
all right,
go
who
ahead.
Is it?
Atlanta.
No!
No.
Not a great, terrible show.
Barry?
Not gonna win. What?
Barry?
What?
HBO?
What a bunch of garbage.
Yeah, I was watching that garbage.
Ass.
Blackish.
It's a really nice show. It's a good show. That's a good show. Big fan. I
Kirby
enjoyed that show.
Kirby Enthusiasm?
Pretty good.
I feel like I didn't pay you enough, Steven, to only root for GLOW right now.
What else?
The Marvelous Mrs. Maisel, which has been seen by 12 people.
There's a show four people watched.
Silicon Valley.
Miss Maisel.
Silicon Valley, which is a great...
It's kind of over.
Well, after TJ Miller left.
It jumped the shark.
Yeah, it's done.
Wants to see that.
And The Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt.
Love.
Which is also on Netflix.
Also
a Netflix show. But yeah, I think GLOW is the best out of all those shows. Here's why. Because you guys are on it, and Mark Maron's on it.
Ugh,
and
Mark Maron.
And you guys are awesome together. What's he like to work with as a... We know him as a comedian.
Yeah.
But what's he like to work with as an actor?
Mark... How do I say this without it getting back to him? No, just kidding. Mark is definitely his character. He is a lovable dick. Like, that's just who he is. He hates people, yet if you talk to him, he's like a really cool guy. But he will never approach you and be like, let's just shoot the shit. Like, he won't do that.
Yeah.
You know, like, he and I actually had a conversation one time where he just all of a sudden in the middle of it just pulled out his phone and started tweeting. And I was just like... Mark, that was rude. And we had a huge conversation about it. And then now it's like, we're friends because I called him out.
Wow, really?
Yeah.
We had a thing happen where he was dating a girl that I knew. And her and I were sitting and watching him do stand-up.
Yeah.
And he was on stage at the Comedy Store doing stand-up. And in the middle of his set, she turns to me and goes, I don't know if he really likes me. I can't tell. Like, I think, like, there's something here, but, like, I don't know if it's, like, really going to be a thing. And as she's saying this, he looks over at her and goes, I'm on a date with this girl, and she can't even focus while I'm on stage. Wow. It's a sold-out main room comedy store. What he's like, what am I supposed to do with this girl? I can't. She's not even paying attention. I'm talking about her right now. She's not even looking. And she's still talking in my ear, like,
God.
I don't know. And I feel, and I go, you may want to turn and look forward. Because everyone in the room was staring at her. It was brutal. Yeah.
Now they're married.
Yeah.
No, they're not.
They do it now.
They're not.
How did you, so go ahead.
I was going to say, like, your characters on your show are loosely based on real people.
Yes.
So, like, when you're preparing, like, you're sort of based on an actual person. Did you meet the person who you're sort of portraying, or?
No. Unfortunately, the woman who my character is inspired by, she recently just passed away, unfortunately, and I wasn't able to meet her. But again, go down a YouTube black hole, people. It's worth your 3 hours.
Oh, yeah.
I watched a lot of her wrestling matches. Her name is Emily Dole. She plays Mount Fiji, and she's phenomenal. Yeah. Like, she's so inspiring. She's such a great person. But yeah, I was a little bit upset. We've met a few of the original GLOW girls, but I did not get a chance to meet her.
Yeah.
What is one of the more difficult things they've had you do?
The most I think probably for me, we have one episode, second season, where I basically wrestle like 5 girls back to back. And for me, I was like, yeah, like the fat chick's gonna get hers. I'm gonna be hella physical. You have to do about 100 takes, and it's a 2-minute wrestling sequence. Oof. After about the first one, I collapsed in the ring and just like laid there and just like started like, we have the best cast and crew, and I just started hearing, Machu, Machu. And it was our cast and crew, like around just being like, you can do it, Britt, like you got it. And I was like, yes, it's gonna be badass. It's 30 seconds in the second season. And most of it is Betty Gilpin doing her voiceover. Like, it really didn't make it in there. And I was like, guys,
you
like
killed yourself for it.
Yeah, and I'm just like, please give me like the DVD commentary cut or something. Yeah.
Something.
It's worth it. It's fun.
When we did Big Time Rush, one of the stunts that I had to do was it was great. I had to get hit in the face with 10 cream pies in a row outside. Like all the, it was a prank show, prank episode. They all had to hit me in the face with cream pies. So it was 10 cream pies. And so I said, they said, do you want to get hit with whipped cream or do you want shaving cream? Which one would you guys choose?
Shaving cream.
See, I took whipped cream.
It's sticky.
I thought that'll be fine. It'll be good. It was 111 degrees outside.
Yeah, you're going to get sticky.
And it got sticky. And then the milk went sour.
Oh.
And then I started getting hit in the face with 10. This was, and there, you know, we're doing 7 or 8 takes. Yeah. So I got hit with 80 sour milk cream pies. They had to put lavender oil up my nose so I wouldn't vomit on the set in front of all these like teenage kids. And I'm just like the old man, like covered in the worst smelling. That was bad. That was a bad one.
That sounds bad.
But it's a check.
Oh yeah.
And it's a show.
Yeah.
And you,
we
you
got
do
it.
And you do the job because it
makes you famous.
It makes you famous.
It makes you famous.
And then you get to be on a podcast. Yes,
you're doing you're doing so well, Stephen. We're very proud.
Appreciate that. Are you? Oh, stop it! Enough already. That's my aunt clapping.
Yeah, I was gonna say it's family table.
Yeah, come on. You were in a Katy Perry music video. Did you get to spend any time with Katy Perry?
No. Met Katy for about 2.5 seconds. Yeah. It was the most like self-indulgent celebrity fest ever. Like,
what?
Backpack Kid was there.
What?
Nicki Minaj. Too many celebrities in a music video that makes no sense. But the fun part about that, and I really wanted to tweet this, but like I kind of like Katy Perry. I have this little thing in my room, just a pocket that has like my goals and wishes, because like I'm that girl that's a nerd. And I wrote down on a piece of paper, I think probably drunk in college, I want to be in a music video where the video has no relation to the song. Mm-hmm. Nailed it.
Wow.
Nailed it.
Really?
And I wanted to tweet and be like, thanks Katy Perry for making one of my dreams come true. But I didn't, because I was like, it's Katy Perry. And it was a check.
Yeah. Right.
We're seriously in the video. Like, it was a bunch of us glow girls. I think Sadell Noel, who plays Cherry Bang, went and like cut up our entire piece. Like, you can't even post it on Instagram. The video's too short. Like, we're not in it. It's insane.
God, that's so weird.
I mean,
I love it. Don't you love that stuff?
That's Hollywood.
We got to get some questions.
We got to get questions from the audience. Questions. We got questions and we got more donuts.
Yeah, I'm on it. Sir, right. What do you want to ask? So I know Chavo Guerrero helped you train.
Yeah.
Did Awesome Kong in any way help with training? And do you think that you've learned enough to work an actual match?
Chavo, love him. Kia Stevens, who is Awesome Kong, she and I had a match the first season and was more helpful to me than anyone could have ever been. She's helpful to us all the time. She's great. You guys, also another YouTube black hole. Just Awesome Kong powerbomb. Do it. What was the second part of your question? No. I mean, I will say I do wrestle a lot and I'm very proud of my wrestling skill, but I now respect the sport too much to walk out there and be like, yeah, I can wrestle. Like, these people dedicate their lives to this sport and to being wrestlers, and that's not my goal. That's not my dream. I enjoy the sport, but I'm never going to walk up and be like, yeah, I can wrestle, because I've been wrestling for like 4 months.
What's something that you haven't done yet in the business that you really want to do? Like, what's something else that's on that list?
I mean, I'm really pushing hard. There's going to be a new plus size superhero movie coming out called Faith.
Whoa.
And I'm like hella pushing hard to try to get that, just because it's like, I'm so scared they're gonna like Bridget Jones it, and they're gonna be like, we tried to like, we brought in 1,000 plus size girls and nobody had it. So Jennifer Lawrence is gonna gain 50 pounds. Like, I'm just really, love Jennifer, but I'm really nervous that's gonna happen. And I want that part bad. She'd be bomb. Like, I'd welcome her to the plus size club and admit it, but.
Let her play the villain.
Yeah.
You know,
like,
come
let
on.
Us battle, but that's what I'm kind of pushing right now.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
I hope that you get it.
Fingers crossed.
We'll
fingers
push
crossed.
For you.
Yep.
Any other questions? Other questions? We got this lady up front.
Right
first
here.
First
here.
Time I've seen her raise her hand all night. Look at her. She's such a beauty.
Okay. Part of the plus size club.
Woo!
Woo! I want to know who your biggest inspiration is.
Ooh. My biggest... I mean, I think this is kind of the cheesy answer, but it really is my mom. I mean, my mom is just a real badass. Like, she is kind of the leader of our tribe, basically. Her and my dad come from a mixed background. They had to go through a lot of adversity to be together and just have a family. So to see a woman go out there and, like, accomplish her dreams and goals and really not care what other people think of her... I think I really just was drawn to that. So Debbie Baldwin, everyone, she's great.
Yeah, nice. Yeah. Good question. Yeah. Well played.
Yeah.
All right, we got
right,
another
right
one
over here.
All right. So when you auditioned for GLOW, did you have any actual remote wrestling experience, or was it one of those things that you put on there, like aerial acrobatics, driving a manual, being able to ride a horse? Was it one of those things that you made up, or was it something that you actually
did? I literally walked in and was like, I can drive a manual. No, so I was a cheerleader in high school. So a lot of, interestingly enough, a lot of the wrestling skills were similar to cheerleading skills. So it wasn't that hard for me. But in the first audition, I did nothing physical. Like, I just... talked with our casting director, Jen Houston, for like 45 minutes, did my scenes and left. A month later, I got called in for a stunt audition with Chavo Guerrero and then our stunt coordinator, who's nominated for an Emmy, Shauna Duggins.
Amazing.
And did a stunt audition, which I found out I was the only girl to do that, whatever. But basically they were just like, do some forward rolls, kick the air, punch. And I was like, cool. Before I left, I looked at both of them. I was like, jump into my arms. And they're like, you're not on insurance. We can't do it. I was like, I was a cheerleader. I can do it. Shauna ran at me. I caught her. She's like, wow, like, you have me. And I was like, great. Then Chavo, I make fun of him for this all the time, being a dick. He's like, you think you can catch me? And I was like, I think I can catch you. Chavo's like a beefy dude. He's like at least 250. He like ran at me and just jumped, and I caught him. He's like, yeah, you got me. And I was like, I walked out, and I was like, this job is mine.
Yeah.
And then literally 2 days later, got the call.
Yeah, that's amazing. Ladies and gentlemen, you gotta love her. She's the best. Watch GLOW on Netflix. Britney Young, everybody. Give it up. Britney Young, everyone. Keep it going.
Oh, man, what a great show.
Oh, Mr. Glickman. That was wonderful.
Oh, hey.
I can't believe the lady didn't eat all the butter, but it was still a wonderful time I had.
Have you been to America before? Is this
no,
your first
this
time?
Is my first time. I had a hot dog this afternoon with mustard and relish.
Wow.
And it was delicious.
Oh, okay.
And I got to see Paris Hilton, or at least a very skinny lady.
Oh, that's so nice.
May I have just a whisker from your beard?
Oh, sure. Here you go. There you go. Take that.
The boys at the pub won't believe it. Oh, thank you.
You bet. Sure. I love England. It's a great place.
I do too. I'm going to take an Uber. Bye-bye now.
Bye.